Happy Friday. How you doing? Hey, today's offering day, and I want to talk to you about how to get your prayers answered 100% of the time. Are you interested in this? I am. This is going to be good. Today's offering day. Today's the day we help send this message around the world. And this message goes around the world. It's all through England, Britain, the United Kingdom, Australia. It's even in the Middle East. How do I look? I have to look good for you people. I happen to know you are a beautiful group of people. We have got to have the most beautiful partners in the world and the most blessed. Huh? We're going to talk about getting our, I'm all about results, getting our prayers answered all the time. Prayers should be answered all, if you pray about something, it should happen for you 100% of the time. Call me. I'll show you how it works. I'll make it work for you. Huh? How's that? I've even gone so far before as to guarantee that I can get your prayers answered. I have that much confidence in God's word that I will guarantee it. Healing, whatever it is you need, guaranteed. Financial increase, if you do what I tell you, you'll get it. Say this with me on this Happy Friday offering day. Make sure you call me today when you do your offerings and your donations, and especially your tithe, so I can speak God's word for word blessing over you. You can't buy the answer to prayer, but we appreciate your offerings and your donations. Amen, because it takes a lot of money to run this thing. And you are responsible for getting it out there. And I appreciate it more than you will ever know. And that money, the truth of the matter is, Paul said in Philippians chapter 4 that when people donated to him, it abounded to their accounts. What account is that? I think it's the same account that Jesus was talking about when he said, lay up for yourself treasure in heaven. Your offerings, your donations, and your tithe leave your hand, but they never leave your life. Never. It is seed planted in the ground on your behalf, and it will grow. Say this with me. The rest of my life is the best of my life. The best of my life is the rest of my life. Everything I touch turns to gold. I am smart, getting smarter every day. I am extremely talented. Great things are coming my way. Everything always works out for me. I am a wonderful person. Pastor Jim is a wonderful pastor. Pastor Jim is the ultimate pastor because he gets results and he's available. Say, I am healed by the stripes of Jesus. I am made rich by the poverty of Jesus. You say those things every day like I do, and you'll live like I live. Your words, will turn your life around. I wrote the book on words. Now, there's all kinds of books about words, but nothing like this one. That will show you how to use your words, how to give your words an assignment. What do you want your words to do? I'll talk about this next week. Do you want your words to cause financial increase? Do you want your words to heal your body? Do you want your words to make your legs stronger? To make your eyes better? To make your brain quick and sharper? Your words can do that. We'll talk about that next week. Amen. Right now, we're talking about prayer. Share this video with everybody you know. Nobody needs to be sick and broke as long as I'm here. As long as I'm here, anybody can be healed, and anybody can live in abundance. Jesus said, the Lord himself said, he says, and whatsoever, in John chapter 14, verse 13, whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified through the Son. Whatever you ask in the name of Jesus, he said he would do. Now, everybody prays in the name of Jesus. But everybody doesn't get results. Why is that? What is the difference between people who get results when they pray and people who don't? I remember years ago, right after I got saved, Mary had taken me out to her church on a Wednesday evening. And it was a small group of people there, maybe 10, 15 people. And the pastor asked this guy, I remember him, his name was Terry. Pastor asked Terry to pray. And so Terry stood up to pray. And I'm telling you what, folks, he prayed the longest, the hardest, the most forceful prayer I ever heard. Now, keep in mind that I grew up in a Lutheran home, going to a Presbyterian church, spent a lot of time in a Methodist church, and graduated from a Catholic college. I was totally confused. Who wouldn't be? I spent my senior year in college, I spent at a Catholic college in Maryland. I mean Catholic. Half the classes were taught by priests. And never heard the name of Jesus. Heard a lot about Buddha and all those other things. And existentialism and ESP and sixth sense and all that, because I was studying psychology and the paranormal and all that, but I never heard the name of Jesus. So I was pretty confused. Well, to hear this guy pray after I had gotten saved was just amazing to me. And I thought to myself when he got to, I mean, you was Father God this, Father God that. We thank you for this. Thank you for that. We ask you for this. We ask you for that. And I mean to tell you, it was loud. And I can't be that loud right now because there's people sleeping in this house. So I have to be loud quietly. How to be loud quietly? That's a good title. So I mean to tell you this, it was just the rafters shook when that guy prayed. And I said to myself, I have to learn how to pray like that. I want to pray like that. Whew. Week or so later, I found out this guy is living out in the woods in a little camper with his wife and 8 kids who are sick all the time. And he's flat broke. And somebody is allowing him to park this cheap, run-down, worn-out camper on their property. Finally, not long after that, somebody took him in, gave him a house to stay in. I realized, because, you know, I'm smart. I realized that's not the way to pray. I realized it doesn't matter how loud you are, how long you pray, how forceful you pray. It doesn't always get answers. I thought to myself, if this guy has so much faith to pray, why is he so sick and broke? Huh? Apparently, something was wrong. Most people who pray. My grandfather was a pastor. My uncle was a hospital chaplain. These people were in the ministry all their lives. They prayed all the time. They prayed for me. They prayed for me when I was born. Some of their prayers got answered. The ones they prayed for me when I was born got answered, but a lot of them didn't. Most people who pray don't even intend to get an answer. They just pray. When somebody calls me with a need, let me tell you something, folks. I intend to get that taken care of. I fully intend that you're going to get what you need. And I will use the power in the name of Jesus to make it happen for you. And I do. And read the testimonies. They're all through my books, these testimonies. And they're also on Facebook. I post them all. If you have a testimony, send it to me in the form of a text message, and I'll post it. I won't use your name or your location, but please share these testimonies. There are so many people out there who have life-changing testimonies. I have a lot of them, but there's a lot of them out there I don't know. There's people who got healed back through the years, got absolute miracles, miracle jobs. Lady said to me one time, she says, I've gotten the two best jobs I've ever had in my life because you prayed for me. Well, I get results. I'll go so far as to say I get results 100% of the time. Now, if you keep your mouth shut, it'll happen for you. But when you come up with all these questions, oh, Pastor Jim, and they want me to keep praying for your kids. Remember, that's what Job did. Job constantly was sacrificing for his kids. Why? Because of fear. And, you know, when you're constantly concerned about your kids, it develops into fear. And fear will destroy you. It destroyed Job. Read it. Please, Job chapter 1, 2, and 3. It was fear. He said, that which I feared has greatly come upon me. Never, ever speak fear. Lady said to me last week, she says, oh, Pastor Jim, I'm so afraid. I said, well, you should be. Because you just loosed the devil in your life. Speaking fear will loose the devil in your life. Please, please be quiet. Once I pray for you, don't say another word. Don't say nothing. And what I prayed for will happen for you. Amen. Because I get results 100% of the time. Once I pray for you or speak over you about something, the answer is coming at you at the speed of light. Just let it come. Let it come. And you'll get it. Just one praise report after another. People losing their keys. People's kids getting off the track. I'll bind the devil in the lives of your kids, and that's the end of it. Because once the devil leaves your kids, they straighten out. How simple is that? But if you keep fussing about it, the devil keeps getting back in there. And every time he gets back in there, it's worse. Remember what Jesus said about that? He brings his friends. Please, you can get prayers answered 100% of the time. You call me. I will pray the prayer of agreement with you and boost your prayer, and we'll get it answered for you. I'm determined you're going to live a curse-free, blessed life. And make sure you call me today when you do your offerings and your donations, because today is offering day, and I want your offering to be blessed. I'm determined you are going to live an abundant life.